So first and foremost, may I give you a very warm, I choose that word, on the day that's in it, a warm welcome to Rubicon 2015. For those who don't know me, my name is Rob Jones. I am the vicar in the local Church of Ireland parish, and I'm also the co-founder of Rubicon with Greg Fromholtz, who will be speaking later on as part of panels and other bits and pieces. This morning as I woke up and the rain was lashing down outside, it was one of those days you wanted to stay in and watch SpongeBob with your daughter. It's one of those Irish days with the rain teeming down. But we're delighted that so many of you have come for this discussion, this conference of Rubicon. Every time that we run Rubicon, people ask me the question, what is Rubicon? I think there is confusion, I kind of like there's a little bit of confusion and tension around the words. But I want to bring some clarity towards what is Rubicon as we kick off this conference in 2015. The term Rubicon, it's a very simple term. You might have heard of it, you might not have heard of it, but it was the river that Julius Caesar crossed around 50 years before Jesus was born. Caesar crossed that river before he reinstated a new authority, a new time, a new season, a new state, a new governance, a new power struggle in Rome. And in his memoirs and in the history of Julius Caesar, he wrote about this idea of, once I crossed the Rubicon, there's no going back. And so in the vernacular of today, you might have heard this idea of a Rubicon moment, of the idea of a shift or a transition, or the idea of not going back. And so once Julius Caesar crossed that river, there was no going back from what he was about to do in Rome. And for us, I believe in Ireland, it's not what they call historical amnesia. There's always been shifts and changes in history over the eons and over the decades and over the millennia and over the centuries. But at the moment, I believe in Ireland is a real Rubicon moment. A lot of things are shifting, a lot of things are changing. That's not a new thing, it's been going on for some time. And for many of us in the church, there has been this interaction and this conversation between culture and faith. And the idea that the church established under Jesus for all time will reign, and some things should never change in the church, and we should hold on to our identity and who we are as a church, but equally there is things that are changing and shifting. And so Rubicon is a discussion around culture and faith. It is a place where we engage on some of the big topics of today. I saw an article in the Irish Times, it was some time ago actually, and I cut out the headline. It said, "The church I love is falling apart." Now I kind of agree with that and I kind of disagree with that, because I don't actually believe the church I love is falling apart, and that some of the key things need to be broken down and some of the key things are very much established. But I think the reality for many of us that there's this shaking going on, and this reality in the church that there is a breaking off and there's crumbling and something's going on. And I believe this is part of God's plan and the reinstatement of some crucial things. You don't have to stress or freak out, but I do think it's important we discuss these things as the church has done for days gone by, whether the Council of Nicaea or Chalcedon or another of the great councils, Vatican II. The church has always discussed and not been afraid to discuss and engage. So Rubicon is that interaction between culture and faith. And on the back of this falling apart, or this idea of shaking, is very much a sense of us being in a paradigm shift. And I saw this article, again, not in the Irish Times, but the idea of the chicken is out of the egg. And for many in the church, it's a sense of maybe feeling exposed, feeling vulnerable, feeling unsure, and a sense of not quite knowing how to handle ourselves in this time of great transition. And again, I think we need more confidence, but equally, a lot of us are in this place, in this paradigm shift. So Rubicon is a safe place to discuss this shift, a safe place to debate, a safe place to listen, a safe place to hear from people who may be different from what you think you believe, and actually listening to them and engaging with them. Rubicon isn't focused on rewriting Orthodox theology that's guided the church for years, but it is about looking at the secondary aspects and the things that are really up for discussion at the moment in our churches today, whatever your tradition or no tradition or a person even of no faith. I said recently to someone, I asked them, explain to me what you think about Rubicon, and we have this discussion around the questions they wanted to be answered and the discussions they wanted to have, things like human sexuality, discussions around the refugee crisis, homelessness, some of the big discussions of the day, and we will be discussing those things in Rubicon today. But I summed it up with them at the end of our cup of coffee in five terms about what Rubicon is about, and I want you to take these terms into the day. Greg will be repeating them, I'll be reminding us of them. And these five terms are: care is the first one. We care for people who have different opinions of us. We have a sense and a love and a desire to care for all people. We respect people of different opinions, and we want this place to be an environment of respect and a place where we listen to one another and respect, especially when someone says something that you might vehemently disagree with. Just put it up on Twitter, just don't say it. The third phrase is Rubicon is a move to action. I really don't want this just to be a discussion, it's a move to action. The church has always discussed and then moved to action, and as Jesus sent us as disciples into the world, he sent us, we go, and it's a move to action, not just a cerebral discussion in a vacuum, an intellectual vacuum, it's a place of action. And so each one of you, I encourage you to take what you hear and put that into practice in your life. The second last phrase is working out faith in unity. And at the end of today, I will pray a collect for unity from the Book of Common Prayer, which is about listening to each other, but moving towards a place of unity, not compromise, but unity. And Jesus said in John 15 that I pray that they may be one. And there's a lot more that will come up around the day around that idea of unity. The last term is facilitation. At each of your tables, there is a highly trained facilitator. They just volunteered last night. And we want this to be a discussion. We want this to be an interaction. And each one of those facilitators will help with the discussion, help you to meet one another, to ask questions, and then that person will feedback with questions to the various speakers throughout the day, and I will help facilitate that also. In relation to that, we don't have any Wi-Fi here in the college, but I'm hoping that you all have good data, and I know Vodafone is on 4G, so if you're with O2, what can I say, we're not going to find you on Twitter. But the Vodafone and 3 networks are very strong, and actually joking apart, O2, you should get data here as well. There is a hashtag, which is hashtag Rubicon15, so please, if you could put that, if you're putting that on Twitter, so afterwards the conversation will be there for all to see. We are recording all talks, and they will be put up on our website, wearerubicon.com, because as part of this ongoing discussion, we want to share these conversations and use them as a resource to those of faith and those seeking faith and those of no faith. Many of the speakers will have some books, some won't, and some will be available at the front here at the back. And if you would like to know more about that speaker, some of their literature is available. So I am about to announce the first speaker in a few moments. Before I do, some practical things which are important. The toilets are out in the main block to my left. You just walk out to my left, and the code for the day is 0000, beginning of all time, out on the door. The toilets are into the left. Please don't go anywhere else in the building, because we might lock you in and you wouldn't want to be there for the whole weekend. And please just use that for the toilets. So you're welcome to Rubicon. We are delighted to have you here. And I mean that with the utmost respect, the utmost care, and the idea that I'm calling us to action and encouraging you into action today as we facilitate this idea of working out your faith and leading us to action. At the end of the day, as I said, I will pray, and I will also have a time of silence just for what's happened in Paris, because I believe that's really shaking a lot of us, and at the end when I prayed this College of Unity, but also share a moment of silence for the dreadful atrocities happening there. So as I reflected on this image of the church I love is falling apart, I think for many of the younger generation, that is particularly pertinent, and a lot of the younger people are really questioning a lot of aspects of faith, and things have been shaken. And I'm delighted to welcome our first speaker, Ruth, who is the editor of The Vox magazine. Now, The Vox magazine is looking at this idea of being at the intersection of faith, life, and reality in the 21st century Ireland. Vox magazine gives voice to Christians who want to engage with one another and with the world around them. And they've just done this great survey for young people around this idea of being in a paradigm shift and looking at some of the questions they have about the church, some of their comments and some of their issues, some of their joys, and a lot of their discussion. So without further ado, I would like you to show your appreciation and welcome up onto the stage, Ruth Garvey-Williams.